This is a video about OBS and the Razer Stargazer. Really good webcam, what I can play around with and what I've actually found out at the moment. Absolutely love it. I'm going to use my laziness from signing on with Windows 10. It just looks at my ugly face and goes, okay, you're pretty enough to get on. But that's not the issue we're having. I bet who's pretty and who's not. Yeah, anyway. The issue is the green screen compatible with the OBS. So you don't need a green screen and things in the background. It's got a dynamic background removal. And trying to set it up on OBS was a pain in the butt. But I believe I've actually found a way around it. I'll link all the stuff in the description that you'll be needing. There's only one file that you're actually really needing. Other than your OBS, obviously. And what we're going to do first of all, now as you guys can tell, I'm on Windows 10. So obviously Windows 7, Windows 8, whatever operating system you're running, I don't know how it's going to work on that one. It might be the same principle, I'm not too sure. But we'll find out. If it works for you guys and you're running a different operating system from me, or even not, just drop a comment and let us know if it worked, and hopefully it does, because I really like helping you guys. So first of all, we're going to go into our apps and features. And we're going to look for a file. Well, that's what. Look for an SDK file. I've probably went straight past it. There it is. Intel RealSense SDK Runtime Core. We're just going to rip that straight out. Out of there once it's finished doing what it's doing. Now, like I said, I searched around the internet for ages. Some people were saying, go here, go there, do this, do that. And I was like, really? Can I not just plug a webcam in and play it? Sadly, it's not quite as easy with the Razer Stargazer if you want the background drop removal. You can't. For an ordinary webcam, it works sweet. Plug and play. It even works on Windows 7, believe it or not, guys, because I was running Windows 7 previously. And I thought, I'll fiddle around with some files, see if I can get the background drop removal to work on Windows 7. It didn't work. I had got Windows 10, fiddled around, done loads of research, smashed my head off the keyboard a few times. The usual stuff that you normally do when something on a computer has been hidden. But anyway, we'll go ahead and remove this SDK file. It's now removed. And the file that we want, believe it or not, is the Intel RS DCM SR300. Now, this is the file I'm using for the Stargazer. When you go onto the Intel website, it'll tell you, make sure you download the correct file. So, it might be the 200. There's two different versions of the 200 for two different things, I'm not quite too sure. But this is the 300. I'll drop the link in the description and you guys can work it out yourselves on what one it is. So let's go ahead and install. Save it works, and maybe should have done it like the real sense 3D camo green screen before I did that to show you guys that it's not actually working at the moment, but let's add it anyway. Nope, it's still not working, as you guys can see. Probably just wait until RealSense 3D camera green screen will probably be available. Okay, so let's get rid of that. If that fix doesn't work for you guys, surprise, I've got another fix for you guys. And you'll never believe where the actual fix is. The fix is in the OBS files itself. How do you get it? Simple. You simply reinstall your OBS to save you from uninstalling and reinstalling and all that crap. You guys can literally just go ahead and do a fresh install. Obviously, not when you're using it, you can't. So what I'll do is I'll run through the visual from the start, run through the installation, take screenshots, and I'll put the screenshots in for you guys, and you can see where I was going and what I was doing. So I'll be right back after having done an install. And we're back, guys. Excuse me. So just done the install. It wasn't a clean install, I just copied over the file basically just so I could get the part of the installation that I needed, which was to install the files. Here's the images. As you can see, it's literally just the core files that's pre-selected that I am installing. Done that, it's successfully installed. Let's see if it'll work. And there you go, guys. Woo, I'm alive. It's installed the core files. The reason I didn't install anything else, need them. I've got my background removal. If I even just do this, you guys can see there is no web, like green screen or anything around. Like I can literally just, there's nothing. Cup of coffee? Anybody? But yeah, there you go, guys. As you can see, it. It works. Core files from the OBS seem to want to make it to work. This was recorded in OBS Studio because the Classic is no longer supported. Sadly, I do prefer the Classic, but need to move on to the Studio. So there you go, guys. That's how you get your Intel. Your Razer Stargazer. That's the one, to work with OBS and the dynamic background removal. So if you guys have any problems, let me know in the comments, I'll try my best to help. One thing is, if you do get it, make sure you've got plenty of light, because I've got really bad lighting at the minute, and as you can see, it's like really buggy as hell, very glitchy. My headphones look like they've got some sort of sparkly stuff. Oh well. But yeah, guys, lots of work and everything. That's how you get it to work. If you haven't already, smash that like button and hit subscribe. Helps the channel out, guys. See you later.